Now, something that all these exchanges use, all the ones that I've signed up for, they use two-factor authentication. And what that is, it's just an extra layer of security saying that, you know, I've verified my email address, but they want another way to prove it's actually me logging in, so no one else can log into the account and steal all my money. So they use two-factor authentication. Also, you see 2FA. That's what it means. Most popular one of these is Google Authenticator. It's a separate app. So if I'm on the security page here, I can see where I can verify my phone number. So if you want to do that later, or you have to do it later, just go from the dashboard, you just go to settings here, and then you go to security, and then there's the place where you can put in your phone number. So if I go down, your two-factor method is none. Your account is not protected by two-step verification! Enable an authenticator, or add a phone number to get started. So I'm going to enable an authenticator. This is the screen that comes up next. Now, this thing that you see here is a QR code. Basically, there are devices which scan this and they will link this with your device. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the Play Store. I basically have an Android phone, and you go to the Play Store and you can download. Let me find it. There we are. Go to the Play Store and I'm going to search for Google Authenticator. You can find it anywhere. Google Authenticator. Very simple to do. Really easy to find. Here it is. So all you see is this, Google Authenticator, and you can uninstall or open it. I'm going to open it. Now, I've already installed this because I've signed up to lots of other exchanges. I just wanted to show you where to get it. So here on my Google Authenticator, you can see some of the other things that I've signed up for. At the bottom here on the right, there's like a little red circle with a button on it. I'm going to press that, okay? When it does, you see scan a barcode and enter a provided key. So I'm going to pick the first one, scan a barcode. And what happens when I do that is this pops up. Now this is a little screen where it's got obviously got like a target. And all you have to do is you have to put this QR code, this one here, you have to put that into the target. So I'm going to do that now. Boom. The second you do, it saves it. It saves it on your phone. And now, Coinbase. There it is, at the bottom. Coinbase social trading blog at gmail.com. So, what that is it's basically that little code, those six digits that you see. Do you see on the right there, there's like a little timer counting down. You can see the circle getting smaller and smaller. When that goes down, the code will change. So each code stays there for a limited amount of time. So now, here on the thing, it says enter the two-step verification code provided by your authentication app. So at the bottom, I see the Coinbase one at the, right at the bottom, and I go 909161. I put that in, enable, and boom, that's it. It's linked it. So I have lots of different authenticators for different exchanges in my one Google Authenticator app. So that's where you'll find them all, basically. And I've got different email accounts and different things. So there we are. That's how you get Google Authenticator. It's really simple to use. Just scan the QR code, scan what's on the actual screen. It will link them. And from then on, you're going to use that Google Authenticator when you make payments, when you take money out of the exchange, when you want to transfer it. It's a very useful second layer of help, really, of security. So your two-factor method is Authenticator, and it's done. Require verification code to send any amount of digital currency. So that's it. That's the most secure way. It means that any amount of digital currency I want to send through Coinbase, it's going to make sure that the code on there matches me. So I type it in, the code that I see at the time on that, and it will know that it's me actually doing it, or whoever's got my phone, but me hopefully doing it. So I'm going to save that. Okay, and it's asking me to do it again. So all I do is I go to my my app again. I'll find it, or Google Authenticator. I go to the bottom, there's my Coinbase one, and I put that in. So anytime I want to make changes, if I want to save something in the settings, it will ask me to do it. I've verified, boom. That's it. Okay. 291996. Now if you get this wrong and it changes whilst you're doing it, don't worry. It'll be fine. Hold on, I'm gonna wait till it changes. 010101. Okay, we're good. Okay, so a bit more about the security of this. Basically, it uses a thing called the TOTP. That's how the Google Authenticator works. It means time-based one-time password. So every 30 seconds, when that little circle sort of goes down, that's a brand new code. Those six digits, that's a new code. That's why I'm showing them on the video, because you can't like use them again. People can't use those again. One thing I did want to show you, remember that screen where I was actually putting in the QR code? So what that QR code is, if you look, the QR code is actually this here. It creates a secret authentication key. All right, that's your secret key. Now, that is up here at the top where I'm putting the arrow. Yeah, I've blocked it out, obviously, because I don't want people to see it. But that key, if something goes wrong or your phone gets stolen or you lose it, you're going to need that key again to sort of reestablish your authenticator. So that key, when you see it, you should write it down. Write it down on a piece of paper and keep it somewhere safe offline, because you might need it again to log in. Okay, so keep that. The QR code over here, which I've also blurred out, all that is it's a visual representation of that secret key, okay? So you remember when I put when I used the Authenticator app and scanned that QR code, on the app you actually saw secret saved, all right? So all it's done, when I scan that little QR code, it reads the secret key, puts it in, and it links my device to the Authenticator. So write down that secret code, keep it safe. That's kind of your backup way in should something go wrong, okay? If you want to find out more about the Google Authenticator, you can go here to the to Google Play, and there's their page, and you can read about how the Authenticator works, what TOTP is. You can also look that up here on Wikipedia, time-based one-time password algorithm. That's basically what it's using, and all this does really is it replaces SMSs. So instead of Coinbase having you to send you an SMS and you verify the code in the SMS, once you use Google Authenticator, the SMSs will stop, and from now on you'll be using Google Authenticator. They use it on a wide range of services now, secure services around the internet, you know, because there's a lot of data leaks and a lot of, you know, so they're just trying to make it more secure. All right, so that's it about the Google Authenticator. That's how you set it up and how you start it with Coinbase. Next video will be how we actually buy the Bitcoin from Coinbase. So yeah, another step on the little journey. There we go. Thanks for watching.